very good day to everyone. I'm T. Hann, third year medical student from IMU. And the topic of my presentation today is the effect of trans-resveratrol on glutamate clearance and visual behaviour due to excitotoxic retina injury in rats. Now, let's look at the relationship between glutamate and glaucoma. So glutamate is the major excitatory neurotransmitter in retina. But excessive glutamate neurotransmission will lead to excitotoxic injury. So normally, when glutamate released from presynaptic cells will bind to its receptor on the postsynaptic cells, which leads to the increase of calcium ion concentration in the cell. The increase of calcium ions concentration will lead to action potential. The glutamate will then clear it out by two routes. The first one is direct uptake from the presynaptic cells, and the second route is the uptake by glial cells through two transporters, which is EAAT1 and EAAT2. But if there is excessive glutamate, this will lead to excitotoxicity. So when there is excessive glutamate, it will lead to excessive calcium ions concentration build up, and these calcium ions will then accumulate in the mitochondria, which will lead to the leakage of cytochrome C. This cytochrome C will bind with APAF1, forming apoptosome, and apoptosome will then activate caspase 9, which then activates caspase 3 and activates apoptosis. And this will lead to glaucoma. And that's why in our research this time, we like to explore more on this substance here, which is called trans-resveratrol. It is widely known for its neuroprotective properties, and it was shown to counteract the hyperglycemia-induced reduction in expressions of EAAT1 and EAAT2 and glutamate clearance in a research in 2016. And it still remains unknown if trans-resveratrol affects EAAT1 and EAAT2 expression and protects against excitotoxicity under non-diabetic condition. Now let's look at the objectives of the project. The first one is to determine the effect of trans-resveratrol on glutamate clearance by measuring the retina glutamate level and EAAT1 and EAAT2 expression using ELISA in rats. And the second one is to determine the effect of trans-resveratrol on glutamate-induced changes in visual behavior of rats using open-field tests and chamber mirror tests. And the third one is to determine the effect of trans-resveratrol on glutamate-induced changes in retina morphology in rats using H&E staining. Now, this is the study design. So we'll separate the rats into five different groups, which is the untreated, the intravitreal vehicle, the intravitreal glutamate group, and intravitreal trans-resveratrol followed by glutamate 24 hours later. And this is our pre-treatment group. And also intravitreal glutamate followed by trans-resveratrol 24 hours later, which is our post-treatment group. And on day 6, the rats went through open field tests. On day 7, they went through chamber mirror tests. And on day 8, I sacrificed them and their eyes were enucleated. And I used ELISA to check for retina expressions of glutamate, EAAT1 and EAAT2 expressions. And I used H&E staining for retina morphology. And I used GraphPad for statistical analysis. We have settings for open field tests and the settings for chamber mirror test here. Now let's look at the result and discussion part. So we can clearly see that rats in intravitreal glutamate injection, expressions of glutamate transporter remains comparable to the PBS group, which perhaps is inadequate to clear up the increased glutamate injected exogenously. Hence, retinal glutamate concentration in this group is high compared to the PBS group. In TR-treated groups, pre-treatment group showed greater expressions of both transporter, and accordingly, the retinal glutamate level was significantly lower in this group. In the trans-resveratrol post-treatment group, we observe a trend towards high expressions of both transporter. However, the difference from GA group was not significant. Accordingly, a significant reduction in glutamate level was not observed, as was the case for pre-treatment group. For the retina morphology, I've selected one picture to represent each group, and the different colors arrows represent different layers of the retina. Now, if you look at the data closely, we'll notice that for the GA rats, they're having the least thickness for all the retina layers, whereas if you look at the treatment group, we'll see that the GATR and the TRGA rats is having the similar results when compared to the UT and the PBS groups. And now let's look at some data from the open field test. And now this is the track plots of the test. We can see that the GA rats spend more time exploring the peripheral zone and less time in the central zone, whereas the others are willingly to explore the central zone more. Overall, there were no difference between the untreated and PBS treated group. However, the GA treated group showed high locomotor but lower exploratory behavior compared to the PPS group. The emotional status was also higher in the GA rats, but overall, this indicates elevated anxiety in GA-treated rats. In trans-resveratrol post-treated rats, we observed the overall behavior closer to the PPS group, but this was more evident in the pre-treatment group that showed overall behavior very close to the PPS group. These observations are in accordance with previously published paper, one of which is listed below. These observations correlate with the difference in the expressions of retinal glutamate transporter and glutamate concentration among various groups. Now, let's look at data from the chamber mirror test. And we can observe the pattern. All other rats, except the GA rats, spend more time in the inverse mirror chamber. According to the graph, the GATR and the TRGA rats had a similar visual status as untreated and control rats. These rats spend more time in the inverse mirror chamber. And this can be explained with a paper published by File and Height in 1978. The paper claimed that when two healthy rats are placed in an unfamiliar test environment, the overall level of social interaction is suppressed. In this case, healthy rats are able to see their reflection clearly in the mirror chamber without knowing that it is their reflection. Therefore, they escape from the mirror chamber to avoid any social interaction with the reflection. We also noticed that no zone preference were observed among the GA rats, and time spent in both mirror and inverse mirror zones were almost equal. All the rats were not subjected to prior training, and the single sessions of tests were performed over 10 minutes. Therefore, it seems that the GA rats have some degree of visual loss that affects their ability to recognize themselves in the mirror, and this is likely to result into their inability to distinguish between mirror and inverse mirror. In conclusion, treatment with trans-resveratrol increases expressions of EAAT1 and EAAT2 and also reduces retinal glutamate concentration in rats. And this suggests that trans-resveratrol enhances glutamate clearance and reduces excitotoxicity. We also can conclude that treatment with trans-resveratrol preserves glutamate-induced changes in visual behavior in rats. And lastly, treatment with trans-resveratrol preserves glutamate-induced changes in retina morphological features. Overall, pre-treatment group showed greater efficacy when compared to the post-treatment group. And this is the end of my presentation. Thank you so much for your time.